Oh, I'm Matt Fender. This is this week's announcements. Today, Friday the 17th, there's a boys' basketball game here against Seymour. That starts at 6 o'clock. On Monday the 20th, there's a girls' basketball game here versus Catholic. That starts at 6 o'clock. Tuesday the 21st, there's a girls' basketball game here against Robertsville at 6 p.m. There's also a boys' basketball game at Cassville that starts at 6 p.m. Final also begin. Good luck with that. Wednesday the 22nd is the last day of finals and we're released for Christmas break. Everybody enjoy. Let's get
it started in here. Smaller schools in the blue division play bigger schools in the gold division.
What are your thoughts and concerns about the blue and gold tournament?
My concerns would be playing number one ranked Nixa, but oh well.
And how are you preparing for the blue and gold tournament?
Well, we're working hard at practice every day and getting better at every one of our games.
Four Big Mud tires, three shotgun shells, two hunting dogs, and some parts to a Mustang GT.
I got my ugly sweater from my dad's girlfriend's mother. I went and got it like 30 minutes before the party. It was pretty awesome. Then I won. Got some Reese's. It's pretty sweet.
Four Big Mud tires, three shotgun shells, two hunting dogs, and some parts to a Mustang GT.
Well, you know, you can't really consider it a Christmas.
All right, so what we did to win this ping pong tournament, actually I won this ping pong tournament second, you know. We worked real hard. I consistently beat Rafael Nadal in tennis, so I figured I was pretty prepared and ran about 5 miles every day. I got pretty tired.
We also got our ping pong paddles out of the dumpster, and we hit golf balls to increase the speed on our ping pong ball. So it was kind of like lifting weights.
My favorite part is getting this pretty TR.
Yummy bears.
Math is a wonderful thing.
Hi, I'm here with Ms. Brisengine, and we're talking about the Academic Bowl from last Saturday. And Ms. Brisengine, how did the first meet go?
It went really well. As a team, we placed second. We had 3 wins, 1 loss. So I'm very proud of my students.
And what was it like to host a meet for the first time?
It was a really good experience. It was a little bit stressful getting volunteers, but a lot of fun.
Hi, Austin. How did the team do on Saturday?
Well, on Saturday we did pretty good. I would have liked it that if most of the other players on the team had done a little bit better, but we did fairly well. We beat everybody besides Branson.
And were there any memorable moments?
There were one that sticks out in my head. It's when the kid from Branson could do math faster than I could.
Math is a really cool thing. Math.
And I go back to a two-tone short bed Chevy, driving my first love out to the levee, living life with no sense of time. And I go back to the feel of a 50-yard line, a blanket, a girl, some raspberry wine, the Christian time will stop right in its tracks.
My favorite memory is in second grade whenever I brought a snake to school for show and tell. And it got out and Miss Everett freaked out on me.
My favorite school memory would be in second grade when Ian Snake got out and I helped him catch it.
My favorite school memory was the first formal dance we had in eighth grade and all my friends got dressed up together and we took a really cute picture and we all still have the picture. So.
My favorite memory from school isn't actually a memory. I fell off the tornado slide in fifth grade and got a concussion and still don't remember what happened.
My favorite school memory is in kindergarten when we made green eggs and ham and I wouldn't eat the eggs because I thought they were moldy.
My favorite elementary memory was playing on the playground and going down the tornado slide.
Our goal with the Life Skills Fair was to introduce students to the realities of living in an adult world. So based on the occupation and their family size, they were given a monthly salary, and then they had to spend that at the various booths throughout the Life Skills Fair. We had housing, transportation, insurance, utilities, child care. Once everybody was done, they came to the SOS booth, and if they were ahead for the month, they got a payday candy bar. If they didn't have enough money to meet all their expenses, they got a zero candy bar.
I learned that you had to plan out using what you wanted and what you needed differently.
I learned that you need to like realize and be reasonable on what you need to buy and get what you need first.
Now that the hot days and warm nights are over, and the cold chill of fall and winter is here, what can you do to avoid the winter blues? Well, here are a few suggestions. It's cold outside, and the wind's howling. What about curling up to a movie? Nothing says winter like Rudolph.
Rudolph, with your nose so bright, won't you guide my sleigh tonight?
Then how the reindeer loved him as they shouted out with glee.
What I like Rudolph doing for winter is sledding with the neighborhood kids.
On cold winter days, I like to stay inside and watch movies.
And I like to go outside and make snow angels and play with all my dogs.
On cold winter days, I enjoy taking strolls in the backcountry.
So embrace the season. Whether you stay inside and become your inner movie mogul or book buff, or go live it up outdoors by making snow angels and throwing snowballs. Just remember, whatever you do, there is no wrong way to enjoy winter.
My favorite Christmas tradition is singing the Christmas songs, Frosty the Snowman.
Favorite Christmas tradition is getting up at 6 a.m. With my kids and singing all of our favorite Christmas carols around the piano.
My favorite thing on Christmas is the atmosphere on Christmas Eve and the Bescherung on Christmas Eve. That's in Germany, the present giving.
My favorite Christmas tradition is getting together with my husband's family all together. There's about 30 or 40 of us, and we do the what we call Chinese gift exchange, and gets very chaotic, but it's fun.
My favorite Christmas tradition is that my in-laws tend to go Griswold on their house.
My favorite family tradition is sitting on the tree as we pass out presents.
My favorite Christmas tradition, well, eating, of course, and also going to my grandmother's house on Christmas Eve. Been doing that since I was a young child, and now we still take my own children and we go to Grandma's house for Christmas Eve and then go home and get ready for a night at home before a big Christmas morning at our house. Merry Christmas!